representative of different communities, our police, lady lieutenant, and everyone else. On this Remembrance Sunday 2022, we continue the observance of the end of the World War I, the war to end all wars, as the armistice came into effect on the 11th day of the 11th month at the 11th hour. And we continue to celebrate it annually for over a century. This is the 104th time we meet. The wars, alas, continue. We should not be naive. Many things have changed, but people remain the same. The wars, unfortunately, will never end until the time when the Lord will establish his everlasting kingdom in our hearts. I hear sometimes people say, well, it's terrible, it shouldn't have happened. 21st century, see, in our day and age. Well, I've said it many times, but is really 21st century different to any other century? We haven't changed. Sin still captures people of all nations, of all levels of society, and it's a delusion to think that something can change really so dramatically. Neither political reforms or parties or policies will be able to deal with the most important question, our heart. While we strive for a better world, the healing can come only through the change of our hearts until he himself establishes his peace in us. But we still have to remember. We are called to hold in remembrance all those who have served our nations in war and peace. That makes us human, raises up our spirit. During the various wars and conflicts, many of the sons and daughters of this nation and other nations have served and have made the ultimate sacrifice. Others returned with visible and invisible wounds of war. The Bible says, for no greater love is there than the one who lays down his life for his friends. And we should be thankful for our veterans and remember the fallen and veterans. And let each of us take time to reflect upon this unique, significant, amazing, all those stories we may have experienced as veterans ourselves, perhaps, ourselves if we have been involved in wars, or those of our family members and our friends. And as we remember these sacrifices, let us God to continue to grant his grace and blessing upon them and upon all of us. And to those who have departed this life, may God grant rest eternal in his eternal heavenly kingdom. Amen. So as we turn to the order of service, let's begin with where we missed the first song. Welcome and introduction.
Thank you. When you go home, tell them from us and say, for your tomorrow and great day today.
This is the time when we lay the wreath and flowers.
home.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, from whose love in Christ we cannot be parted either by death or life, hear our prayers and thanksgivings for all whom we remember this day. Fulfill in them the purpose of your love and bring us all with them to your eternal joy through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And now let us commit ourselves to responsible living and faithful service. Will you strive for all that makes for peace?
We will.
Will you seek to heal the wounds of war?
We will.
Will you work for a just future for all humanity?
We will.
Lord God, our Father, we pledge ourselves to serve you and all humanity in the cause of peace, for the relief of want and suffering, and for the praise of your name. Guide us by your Spirit, give us wisdom, give us courage, give us hope, and keep us faithful now and always.
Amen.
Let's finish by singing the national anthem. Departed rest to the Church, the King, the Commonwealth, and all people, peace and concord, and to us and all his servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you and with all those whom you love and remember. Now and always.
Amen.
The act of remembrance is finished, but I just want to add that there's no need for us to remember our loved ones and our veterans only once a year. Let's keep them always in our hearts. And let us always pray for peace every day. We need it.